take the microscope and you're aiming for the little hole.
The work going on in this lab takes a steady hand.
Persistence.
Patience is practiced every day.
This kind of research is very atypical for undergraduates. So it is very much more so the kind of research that's done by graduate students or postdocs who do it for months or years nonstop, right? And there's a steep learning curve.
Will Eastham, Jennifer Aguayo, and Aidan Litt are taking on the challenge. They're working with Professor Jai Shanata for the Cornell Summer Research Institute. Professor Shanata pushed for these early chemistry research opportunities, designing guidelines for the students to ensure their success and to prepare them for the future. This summer, each of their research topics are different, but connected.
The connection eventually is about thinking about how all kinds of molecules move, not just in the body, but through the environment and in the body.
Eastham is studying data and modeling molecules called polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, which are known to be carcinogenic.
They are commonly found in things like oils. They're also found in things like smoke from car exhaust or cigarette smoke. But the concern is that in the case of an oil spill, how do they disperse into the water? Do they disperse in the water? And then how would oil dispersants affect whether or not the polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons will move from the oil to the water?
Aguayo is studying a disease called essential tremors, which causes tremors in different parts of the body.
The goal is to figure out if there is pretty much an indirect mechanism by which the drugs are actually affecting the body. So if we can almost provide evidence for the fact that drugs are actually going and integrating themselves into the cell membrane instead of acting by a way of a receptor or something like that, then we can provide future research or a place for future research.
Litt is examining resveratrol, a compound found in red wine. Studies have shown resveratrol has a number of health properties. His research looks at how it impacts proteins, which he describes as channels that bridge the outside and inside of the cell.
I'm seeing whether or not if you add this resveratrol or like its metabolites, the things that like it's turned into and digested into by the body, then if it has any significant impact on how these channels function.
So our rule is try to keep it below 1%.
In the long run, pieces of these summer research projects will contribute to a bigger research effort that aims to discover the connection between our cells, the drugs we take, and our diet.
Many people take multiple drugs, and there's a lot of effort going into how those drugs interact with one another, either directly or just the fact that when I take one drug, if I take another one, what's going to happen? So doctors have to be very careful about that sort of thing. There's a little bit less thought going into what are sometimes called drug-food interactions. So how what we eat impacts how drugs work and the other side of that. And almost all of that research is focused on the downsides. Take this drug. When you take it, don't eat this. Right? We're interested in seeing to what extent we can maybe exploit that relationship. So are there ways in which we can change how patients eat when they start taking a specific drug to either increase the desired effects or decrease side effects?
Through all of this work that requires persistence and patience, they're working side by side with Professor Shanata. That's something he knows will pay off.
The Cornell Summer Research Institute, I think, is a great thing. I'm a Cornell alum, so I was a student here 2001 through 2005, and I did summer research with Charlie Labrico, actually, when I was a student here. And one of the aspects that I thought was very useful to my career and my development as a graduate student and into a faculty member was that one-on-one interaction and that small group interaction I had with Charlie.
This is just one story detailing all of the summer research projects going on at Cornell College. Watch for others on the Cornell College News Center or follow us on Facebook for more information.